Okay, 612 Castlefield. We've done two exploratory dig trenches, one within the minimum tree protection zone of the city-owned sugar maple, Acer saccharum, and then another in the minimum tree protection zone of the city-owned honey locust, Gladitzia triacanthos varinermis, as well as a privately owned mulberry, Morris alba, over here. Now these trenches are on the other side of this fence, so we're gonna walk around there. The trench in the minimum tree protection zone of the sugar maple is at the extent of the proposed new building. So, here's the existing building. Here's the trench we've done. This trench is approximately 1.5 meters east of the trunk of this tree at its closest point. This trench runs to the extent of the minimum tree protection zone of the tree and where the proposed building is, foundation. We have a large mat of roots here, you know. Largest diameters are around 6 centimeters, but the majority of them are, you know, 1 to 2 centimeters, 3 centimeters, this kind of thing. And moving on to our second trench here. This is for a proposed cabana. Probably a slab on grade type cabana with a, you know, probably need a minimum of 6 inch or 15 centimeters digging below ground. So this trench is almost at the limit of this minimum tree protection zone of this honey locust, which is a 3.6 meter tree protection zone, and this trench is 3.3 meters at its closest point. We've got very large roots. This one's approximately 7 centimeters. Moving along in the trench, roots seem to be at their highest concentration and size, you know, at the closest point to the tree. We have an 8 centimeter root here, 4 centimeter root here, 5 centimeter root here, another root there. This root is from the mulberry over there. Got a smooth root here, irrigation. And some other roots along there. The northern section of the cabana comes along here, where my foot is. That line, and that directly intersects with two major structural roots, one here and another here, right here. Those are both within the minimum tree protection zone of this tree, so it's this tree is not the greatest either. Poor location, invasive tree species, non-native, leaning, interference with overhead wires. So it's my suggestion here to just remove this tree, and then also build outside the minimum tree protection zone of the city-owned tree to preserve these roots as much as possible. As far as down there, we'll have to go back to the drawing board because proposed injury is too great at this point in time.